Hey, okay, this is, I think, we're still on part five. I'm doing and reading this common law trust tax exempt foreign status public notice public record. Okay, I left off at I am not a 26 U.S.C. 7203 person required. I am a non-taxpayer outside both general and tangential venue and jurisdiction of the 26 United States codes. The public record being the highest form of evidence, freeborn spiritual being on the land, being of sound mind, competent over the age of 18, do hereby certify, verify, state, claim, declare forever, without abandonment, real property on earth, personal property, body, and ecclesiastical property, soul, together with all trusts, probate, rights, titles, interests, droit, both absolute and contingent, as are due and as might become due, now existing and as might thereafter arise, and as might be suffered. by imposed on and incurred by debtor for any and every reason, purpose, and cause whatsoever. Private defined, affecting and belonging to private individuals as distinct from the public generally, not official, not clothed with office. People versus Powell, 280 Michigan 699,274, NW 372,373, Black's Law Dictionary, 6th edition, page 1,195. Sue jurist known as Carol Lee of the genealogy of Bohan and freeborn spiritual being on the land state the facts contained herein are true, correct, complete, and not misleading to the best of my personal first-hand knowledge and belief, being of sound mind, competent over the age of 18, this my free will, voluntary act, and deed to make, execute, seal, acknowledge, and deliver under my hand and seal with explicit reservation of all my inalienable rights and my specific common law right not to be bound by any contract or obligation which I have not entered into knowingly, willingly, voluntarily, and without misrepresentation, duress, or coercion, whereby I did not sign nor consent. I am not now, nor have ever been, a U.S. citizen or a 14th Amendment federal citizen or employee. I am not bound by sworn oath or oath of office, whereas I hereby disclaim clauses 1 and 2 of section 1 to the 14th Amendment, together with Article 4, Section 3, Clause 2, without the U.S. Should this not be true, then let the record be corrected, or it will stand as truth. Time is of the essence. Veracity in my private capacity as general executor, executrix of said Sesta Cavey Trust, estate, account, droit, Droit. This serves notice that your offer has been accepted as valuable consideration and returned for value. This property is exempt from levy. Please adjust this account for the proceeds, products, accounts, and fixtures, and release the orders of the court to me immediately. Make adjustment and close this account immediately with prejudice. I accept your oath of office, security agreement, constitutions as bylaws, and malfeasance bond, and place you in the private commencing this self-executing binding contract between you and I. Further, I appoint you trustee, fully personally liable, now on your honor and solemn oath to perform your obligation and duties to protect my inalienable rights in your fiduciary capacity against any and all claims, legal actions, orders, warrants, judgments, demands, liabilities, losses, foreclosure, depositions, summonses, lawsuits, costs, fines, liens, levies, penalties, taxes, damages, interests, and expenses whatsoever, both absolute and contingent, as are due and as might become due, now existing, and as might hereinafter arise, and as might be suffered by, imposed on, and incurred by debtor for any and every reason, purpose, and cause whatsoever. Please honor obligation of good faith and performance of your duties, quid pro quo, an equal exchange or substitution. This my free will, voluntary act, and deed true, and lawful attorney in fact, to make, execute, seal, knowledge, and deliver under my hand and seal. There you go. Notarized. That was done on the 5th, 2021. March 5th. All right. It does with that one. Last one. This is Kentucky. I'm naming it. All right. You are all employees of the state, wherefore benefiting from the actions you take and are based against the people, you are biased against the people for self-government. It appears that you are conspiring, collectively coercing, and colluding to cause harm in my private capacity, wherein your signed anti-bribery statement precludes you from participating in such actions as well as your oaths. Furthermore, 18 U.S.C. Subsection 242, deprivation of rights under color of law. Whoever under color of any law, statute, ordinance, regulation, or custom willfully subjects any person in any state, territory, commonwealth, possession, or district to the deprivation of any rights, privileges, or immunities secured or protected by the Constitution or laws of the United States are to different or to different punishments, pains, or penalties on account of such person being an alien or by reason of his color or race that are prescribed for the punishment of citizens shall be fined under this title or imprisoned not more than 1 year or both, and if bodily injury results from the acts committed in violation of this section, or if such acts include the use, attempted use, or threatened use of a dangerous weapon, explosives, or fire, shall be fined under this title or imprisoned not more than 10 years or both, and if death results from the acts committed in violation of this section, or if such acts include kidnapping or an attempt to kidnap, aggravate sexual abuse, or an attempt to commit, aggravate sexual abuse, or an attempt to kill, shall be fined under this title, or imprisoned for any term of years, or for life, or for both, or may be sentenced to death. June 25th, 1948, Chapter 645, 62 Stat, 696, Public Law 90-284, Title 1, Subsection 103B, is it boy? April 11th, 1968, 82 Stat through 70, wait a minute, 82 Stat 75, Public Law 100-690, Title 7, Subsection 7019, November 18th, 1988, 102 Stat 4396, Public Law 103-322, Title 6, Subsection 60006, B as in boy, Title XXX11, Subsection 3201-03, B as in boy, 320201, B as in boy, Title XXX111, Subsection 330016, 1 in parentheses, and H as in Harry, September 13, 1994, 108 Stat, 1970, 2109, 2113, 2147, Public Law 103-274, Title 6, Subsection 604, B as in boy, 14, and capital B as in boy, 607A, October 11, 1996, 110 Stat, 3507, 3511, 18 U.S.C. Code, 242. Oh, well, I just read that. I don't know what the hell I did. I copied it twice. Okay. Class B felons. Well, let's see. Abuse of the public trust. If the value of the public money or property at issue is $100,000 or more and results in disqualification from any public office, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 522.050, sentence of between 10 and 20 years, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 532.060, fine of between $1,000 and $10,000, or double the gain from the commission of the offense, whichever is greater, Kentucky Revised Statute, and subsection 534.030, Class C felonies, bribery, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 521.020, attempt to provide a pecuniary benefit for bribery, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 521.050, Abuse of public trust if the value of public money or property at issue is between $10,000 and $100,000 and results in disqualification from any public office, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 522.050. Sentence of between 5 and 10 years, Kentucky Revised Statute, subsection 532.060, fine of between $1,000 and $10,000, or double the gain from the commission of the offense, whichever is greater, Kentucky Revised Statute, and subsection 534.030. Class D felonies, misuse of confidential information, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 522.040, abuse of public trust if the value of the public money or property at issue is less than $10,000 and results in disqualification from any public office, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 522.050. Use of official position or office to obtain financial gain for him or herself, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6731. Intentional disclosure or use of confidential information acquired in the course of official duties, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.734, undertaking prohibited kinds of contracts with a state agency, Kentucky Revised Statute, and subsection 6.737, violation of the conflict of interest prohibition, Kentucky Revised Statute, and subsection 6.761, fine of between $1,000 and $10,000 or double the gain from the commission of the offense, whichever is greater, Kentucky Revised Statute, and subsection 534.030, sentence of between 1 and 5 years, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 532.060. Class A misdemeanors, unlawful compensation for assistance in public matters, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 521.040. First degree of official misconduct, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 522.020. Attempt to use influence as a member of the General Assembly in any matter that involves a substantial conflict of interest, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.731. Use the official positions to secure or create privileges, exemptions, advantages, or treatment for himself or herself or others in contravention of the public interest, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.731, use of public funds, time, personal for private gain, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.731, use of public resources for partisan political activities, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.731, knowingly accepting compensation other than that provided by law for performance of legislative duties, deficient or false filings, which includes a penalty of up to $100 a day, not to exceed $1,000 total, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.797, and Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.751, sentence of imprisonment not to exceed 12 months, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 532.090, fine of no more than 500, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 534.040. Class B misdemeanor, soliciting unlawful compensation, Kentucky Revised Stat and subsection 521.020, second degree official misconduct, Kentucky Revised Stat and subsection 522.030, accepting anything of value from a legislative agent or employee, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.751, sentence of imprisonment not to exceed 90 days, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 532.090, fine of no more than 250, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 534.040. Violations of the Code of Legislative Ethics may constitute ethical misconduct, Kentucky Revised Stat and subsection 6.611, over which the Legislative Ethics Commission has jurisdiction and may issue civil penalties or recommend discipline to be voted upon by the respective chamber from which a violator originated, Kentucky Revised Statute and subsection 6.666. Yeah. All right, 28 U.S. Code, subsection 453, Oaths of Justices and Judges, U.S. Code. Each justice or judge of the United States shall take the following oath or affirmation before performing the duties of his office. I, whomever, do solemnly swear or affirm that I will administer justice without respect to persons and do equal rights to the poor and to the rich, and that I will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all the duties incumbent upon me as whatever under the Constitution and laws of the United States. So help me God. June 25th, 1948, Chapter 646, 62 Stat 907, Public Law 101 through 650, Title 4, Subsection 404, December 1st, 1990, 104 Stat 5124. 741 F 2nd 336 Trezevant versus City of Tampa, Federal Reporter second series. Alright, this is where Trezevant was put into jail for refusing to ID because he had not committed a crime. And anyway, let me see if this is the number on the case. Well, you can look it up yourself. But anyway, he was supposed to have gone to the bond agent. I'm not going to read the whole case, but I do have it. And he was supposed to have been taken to the bond agent and then released. And he was going to file a case against the city of Tampa and against the police department for illegally arresting him. And that's assault and battery, which is what they did to me on January 16th. So, you know, there's a lot of things to this. I'm not going to sit here and read it all because of my throat, because my RA has escalated to a freaking whole new freaking level. And I'm hoarse from coughing so much because the inflammation that has escalated into my body from all the stress and the abuse that they have inflicted upon me, the living woman, when I don't have a daggone thing to do with the all caps name, which is corporate. And those of you that are out there that know about this stuff, because tonight my reading all this stuff is not for the education of everything I know. I'm just bringing you up to date on what's going on. So I ended up getting incarcerated January 16th. Told me to step out, they was going to arrest me. They still have my tape recorder, and they still have my Sony camcorder, which is why I'm not doing the news right now much. And they took my phone as well, a cheapo flip phone. They had to take that too, but they did it without a warrant, all right? But I'm not under their United States codes or their Admiralty Maritime Territorial or Municipal laws that has to do with the United States corporation, as because I'm not a citizen. I have expatriated, as I read all this in the first video and showed you the documented proof. And this is only what I showed tonight, was what has been recorded with the American State National and Assembly. But it was recorded more than a year and a half ago down in Georgia in the public record. And so now it's been recorded again in Kentucky with the Kentucky State Assembly for the American State Nationals. So anyhow, they do not have jurisdiction. They have intimidated me. They have threatened me. They have threatened me with being arrested again, not having my freedom as a living woman to use my private conveyance and my private property, which they freaking thieved out of my truck, stole $230, and stole two boxes of ammo, and damaged a package for one of those life straws, and I don't know what the hell else. Broke my window out on the right side of my truck, which Ford Motor Company does not any longer make. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to get a new window, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to afford some glass company to put the daggone thing in. So I've still got glass all over my driveway, in the grass, in the front of the truck, in the dashboard.